is the Bloody Disgusting Podcast Network.
This October 25th, Blood Lane, Alameda Entertainment, and One Fox Productions brings you Frank, a film by Chrissy Fox. A wild tale that will remind you why you're afraid of the dark. In a moment of desperation, Ruby Chase makes a lifetime vow of servitude to a monster, but breaks their deal by committing suicide. Now angered, the monster Frank sets out on a course of bloody revenge, all leading to the one Ruby loved the most. See it on VOD and streaming platforms this October 25th, starring Chrissy Fox, Bonnie Ahrens, Asher Parsons, Lindsay LaRose, and Adam Bush. Make Frank a part of your Halloween, if you're not too scared.
The following contains mature subject matter, coarse language, intense situations, and is meant for an adult audience. Listener discretion is advised. The open road is paved with possibilities and connections. It can also be a detour into unspeakable evil. Bleeders Digest, issue number 18. The Thing in the Road.
This story is called The Thing in the Road, written by Chrissy Fox. I'm Katie Cassidy, and I'm the voice of Willow. I scrambled around the living room like a madwoman. Why does it look like a bomb went off in here? My sister Jessie is uptight, not in a bad way or anything, but she will judge me hard if things aren't in order around here. I glance over at the clock staring down at me on the mantel. Fuck. She should be here in a little less than 2 hours. I clear the dishes off the coffee table. Stuff like this piles up when you live alone and have no one to answer to. Sometimes I don't even want to fucking clean up, so I don't. Look, I'm busy, man. The first thing my sister will do when she gets here is start cleaning my house that in my eyes is spotless. But not to her. Not even close. It's annoying, but honestly, I secretly kind of like being taken care of for once. I'm the big sister, and growing up, I always had the motherly role. As I got older, I pulled further and further away from it, and my sister, she became Martha fucking Stewart. It's kind of annoying. But then again, she does always stock my freezer with homemade meals before she leaves. All healthy and vegan and super fucking delicious. I tear up the living room looking for my cell phone. Pulling up a couch cushion, I find it nestled in the crack. Gross. There is enough crumbs under here to feed someone for a few days. Jessie will be disappointed for sure. I dial my phone, putting the phone on speaker so I can keep cleaning.
Hello, poodle butt.
Hi, dickface. How's the drive?
Dark. Like, for 7 hours. Why do you live out here? I don't want to think what will happen if I run out of gas.
I'm sure there's gas stations around.
Nope. Most I've seen is a wild fucking horse walking along this bumpy as fuck road. How is this even a highway? It's barely even one lane.
You saw a horse?
It looked like it'd been through a lot. Oh, fuck.
What? What's wrong?
Dude, it's starting to snow. This is just stupid. It's only October. Can you just move home already? You followed Doucheface out here. It didn't work. Out here sucks. Come home.
Yeah, I felt the same way at first, but I actually kind of like it. I made some real, actual friends, and it's like a little community. I can't stand people back home. They always made me miserable.
I'm there.
I know. You're the only thing I miss.
What about Mom?
Meh.
Yeah, she's up my ass so much now without you around stressing her out.
Oh, you're welcome.
Okay, cool. I have to drive so fucking slow because it's icy now and I can't see dick.
You should have done the drive over 2 days. I already told you that.
Yeah. The only motel I've seen in hours is where you'd go for a drive-through rape and murder.
Sounds nice.
At this point, I'd kill for a hitchhiker or something to keep me company.
Oh, I'm never good enough.
What the fuck is that in the road?
Don't be creeping me out.
Is that a wolf head? Oh, shit!
Jess? Jess! Jess, what the fuck? Are you okay?
No!
No, 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 Jessie! 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 Jessie!
Jesse! Jesse, fucking answer me! Jesse, are you okay? Oh my god. Oh my god, please, please. I'll call for help. Fuck. Fuck, I don't want to hang up. I'm not sure, Jesse. Jesse, exactly where you are. Jesse. Jesse, can you answer me? Answer me, damn it! I gotta call someone. Jesse.
Don't hang up.
Oh my god. Oh my god, are you okay? Did you crash? Where are you? Where? Jesse.
I think I'm dying. There's blood. It's cold.
No, you're not dying. Listen to me. Look around. What do you see?
I'm upside down. I got a head rush. My seatbelt stuck.
What can... Is there something you can cut with? Look around you. Stay with me.
I don't.
Jesse! Jesse!
Known that for quite some time.
Jesse, wake up! Answer me! Jesse, you have to answer me! Jesse, you have to wake up. Please, Jesse, just send me your location. I'm afraid I'm going to lose reception out on the road, and it goes in and out, and what do I do?
Shh! Drive too slow in this lost land. He will come for you. It is not a man. Evil as it walks, evil in its breath. You came into its home.
Did you hit your head?
No. It's what I saw, I swear. I'm really tired.
Stay awake. Stay awake. Look around. Just look around. What do you see?
It hurts. It's just dark. I'm in the woods. Willow, I don't see the road anywhere.
How? You're on flatlands. You couldn't have rolled off the highway. I've driven it a million times. You can see forever every way you look.
I don't know. Willow, I hear something.
What do you mean? Like a car? Something else? Are you sure it's not somebody who could help?
No. It's not.
Jesse, what do you see? What do you see?
This is my home.
It's time for you
to run. Time too slow in this lost land. He will come for you. It is not a man. Evil as it walks, evil in its breath.
off.
Jesse! Jesse! Jesse, what was that?
My seatbelt. It just unbuckled on its own. I fell. The car's upside down and I'm on the ceiling.
Can you get out?
Well, something's out there.
Maybe it's gone.
Oh my God.
What? What? Jesse, I'm so scared. What?
I see it. It's watching me.
What? Damn it! What?
That thing from the road.
Lock the doors. Lock the doors! What is that?
It's on top of the car. Oh my God, please.
Jesse?
Yeah?
Run. I'm standing here holding my phone, and the prayers playing in the distance. A sound that is so far from human begins to rise on the other end of my phone. I'm not even kidding, my smartphone begins to smoke and shorts out. I throw it as if it was burning to the touch. I'm standing in my mostly tidy living room in stunned and devastated shock. I try to calm my breath. Should I run next door and get my neighbor to call for help? Yeah, of course, that's what I'll do. That's what I should do. I take a step and freeze as I hear my downstairs door unlock. Who the fuck is that? Other than my ex, the only one who has a key is my sister. Someone enters the house. I stand there, frozen. Oh, footsteps approaching the stairs. Hello? I call. The footsteps slowly begin to climb the stairs, headed towards me. They've reached the second floor. I hear my sister's voice.
It's me.
The power goes out. It's pitch black. I can hear the floor creak. Something I know is not my sister. Slowly approaches me. From my bedroom down the hall, I hear my old school alarm clock radio turn on. The prayer I've gotten to know so well begins to play.
Time goes slow in this lost land. It will come for you. It is not a man. Evil as it walks, evil in its breath. You came into its home, and no one's ever left.
The radio station begins to switch rapidly again, and I hear...
This is... My... home.
It's time for you.
The radio goes silent. I smell putrid breath. It's what you would imagine death would smell like.
It's warm on my face. Oh, God. It must be right in front of me.
Time goes slow in this lost land. He will come for you. It is not a man. Evil as it walks, evil in its breath. You came into its home, and no one's ever left.
The Thing in the Road, written by Chrissy Fox, featuring Katie Cassidy as Willow. Chrissy Fox as Jesse and radio announcers. Tyler Connolly as the prayer and radio announcers. Spider One as radio announcers. Yes, that's a hell of a lot of radio announcers, because that's just how we roll. Engineered by Tyler Connolly. Production, sound design, and music by Chrissy Fox. Theme music by Tyler Connolly, Chrissy Fox, and Trevor Shand. Bleeder's Digest is created and curated by Spider One, Chrissy Fox, Trevor Shand, and Lauren Shand. Subscribe on your favorite podcast provider to never miss an episode. Bleeder's Digest is a presentation of the Bloody Disgusting Podcast Network. It's the Bleeder's Digest post show!
I'm Lauren.
I'm Trevor.
I'm Chrissy.
And I'm Spider.
That was episode... What's that? What were we going to say?
All right, I was doing the post show.
Oh, post show! So that was episode 18, The Thing in the Road, written by Chrissy Fox, and it's part of Bleeder's Digest special Halloween month of programming featuring special guest actors and narrators from the horror community and your favorite genre films and projects. And performing in The Thing in the Road was
Katie Cassidy. Woo. She was so good in this. I was like blown away. I think when she first said she would do it, she would like didn't even know what she was getting into, and she was just like on right away. I had to say nothing. She was just like so great. So I'm super super excited about the story and her performance.
And she was in the remake of When a Stranger Calls and Black Christmas and Nightmare on Elm Street, and she's been in a ton of TV projects like Supernatural, and she played Black Canary on CW's Arrow, and she's got a really cool fucking voice.
She does. She has a great voice.
Like a texture to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. She's got a great voice. She should be doing this all the time because she's badass. But, and she does art, and she's a really impressive girl.
My question to you is, how did you come up with this story and that twisted prayer that we hear? And is that Spider doing the prayer?
No, it's actually Tyler. Then
really? Yeah.
And then I just like mess with his voice. Well, it's actually a really funny story. I posted just like the little clip of the teaser before the episode, and my bass player from my band DM'd me. He's like, this, I don't know the whole story, but this sounds like tour. And that's totally where it came from. There's a couple specific things that happened when we were on tour together in this story, when she talked about the wolf head in the road and the horses. This was actually like, we drove down this really long, I think it was in New Mexico, for hours and hours in the dark. And it was just, and we actually saw a wolf head in the middle of the road.
What
there was horses.
What?
It was so scary.
Well, it was Navajo Nation.
That's right. That's where it was.
Yeah. So we would do, wow. We did a show. We've done a bunch of shows over the years for Navajo Nation on the reservations. And so like, it's a whole different world. You know, you get on the res and they're always like super accommodating. They're so into rock and stuff, but yeah, you drive like,
getting there
in the middle of nowhere
and, for hours,
like wild horses running around and lots of like wild dogs. It's really cool.
It's really crazy. And so it was like the combination of that, and then this other night we were in Texas and we were on our way to Corpus Christi, and we're like in the nothingness area of Texas just driving in the middle of the night, and my bass player was driving, and actually Spider was riding with us, and we were in the back, but we were like talking to him looking out the window. And it was like pitch black, like single lane. And all of a sudden, I told my bass player, I'm like, just turn the high beams on. Why aren't the high beams on? It's so foggy. And he did. And some dude was in the middle of the road and ran full speed at the vehicle.
Oh, my God.
And he swerved. And we're like, ah! And then he's like screaming and trying to get us to stop. And I'm like, we can't stop. Like, this is a trap.
Fuck no. Yeah. Yeah.
So there's a lot of like those things that inspired this. And then I thought, like, what would happen if, like, you just crossed over into some evil entities, like place that you shouldn't have crashed. And it was just like, Yeah. And then this prayer just keeps coming back. And once basically you've been there, you can't get away from it. And because the sister heard it, she can't get away from it either. And I thought that was a really scary concept. And we spend a lot of time on the road talking about what would happen if we just scared the shit out of each other. So, you know, it was a lot of inspo there.
Yeah, I would imagine just being on the road late night, driving around as a band.
You always see the, you're driving, you know, because most of the country, you can drive for hours and hours and see nothing.
Yeah.
You know, and then all of a sudden there's that weird little house, you know, in the distance.
Right in the middle of fucking nowhere.
Yeah,
that same night, Spider, do you remember we stopped at this hotel and we didn't realize it at first. And we realized it the next morning, like in the cracks of the doorway, there was like swastikas in the lobby of the hotel.
We didn't see this until
like the next morning. But like, then we like go into these rooms and it's like motel style. And for some reason, like we look, it just felt off. And the entire parking lot was just full of these white vans, but that was it. And so the whole night I was so freaked out. And it was the same night as the guy running at the car. And I'm like, there's some like weird, like cult shit going down. Like, you know, so
where was this?
Yeah, it was like on our way to Corpus Christi, middle of fucking nowhere, pitch black, nothing. And like, we just like, we need to stop for the night. A lot of times when you're on tour, you're trying to get from one place to another and there's a lot of nothingness in between. And so you just have to like make do. And we had to stop. We were so tired. So we found this hotel, but yeah, the next morning, I think we went in to go check out and we like, were like, oh my God. And we saw like in the cracks of the doorways, this was all these like, yeah, swastika symbols and stuff were all scraped into the doorways. And it was just really bizarre, really scary. And we probably would have never, ever stayed there if we had saw that in that night. So we're all alive. So that's what matters. Whoa. But yeah, it was weird.
Sometimes I've talked to bands or I've been in bands where, you know, when bands are just starting out and they're doing their own independent touring and stuff and they'll play at people's house parties and things like that. And you'll set up tours like that. You end up staying at people's houses, not necessarily motels. Have you had any freaky as shit experiences staying at someone's house while in a band on the road? You know, you just crash at whoever's arranging the show or whatever.
You know, I've always consciously just avoided it. I've been offered it a lot, but I just know it's a nightmare waiting to happen. But there's certainly been green rooms that have been beyond scary.
Touring in Power Man, never crashed anybody's house, but I did. It's not that scary of a story. It's a pretty cool story. So the very first tour that White Zombie ever did was like a little tour from New York through the Midwest, and I had just dropped out of art school, and so I volunteered to drive the van. And so we ended up crashing. They did a show in Chicago. I think it was Chicago. And we ended up crashing at this house. And the house ended up being the house where the guys from Urge Overkill live. And Steve Albini, if anybody knows who Steve Albini is, like a famous producer, ended up producing Nirvana. And so he had his home. That was his home studio. Like long before Nirvana and all this stuff.
That's
so
crazy.
We stayed at Steve Albini's house. And then so all that was pretty uneventful other than being kind of a cool rock history thing. But the weirdest thing was the guy from Urge Overkill. He's like, you want to watch this really cool video? And I was like, yeah. And so he shows me the video of the very famous video that the song Hey Man, I Shot is based on, of that politician guy who shoots himself in the face live on TV.
Bud Dwyer. Yeah.
So he showed me this video and it just fucked with me. Like the whole rest of the like week, I was just like shaking. It was so disturbing. So yeah, that was a story from staying at somebody's house.
Jeez. Yeah, that video definitely stays with you, right? You think you could take it when someone explains it to you, but when you actually see it, and the reality of it,
it's like you know that manila envelope on the podium has a gun in it, and he's going through the motion of, you know, giving this speech, and then he pulls the gun out, and no one really notices at first, and everyone starts pleading with him, like, no, no, no. And then it's not like you see in the movies. you know, with this clean sort of splat against the wall. That's what fucked me up, was just what it really looks like when someone shoots themselves in the mouth. And it was just like faucets turned on full, like a blood just coming from his eyes, his nose, his mouth. It was, it's horrifying.
Well, yeah. I'm happy we can cheer everybody up tonight. Well, so that's good.
Yeah. Well, you brought it up. Happy Halloween, everybody. Yeah. But anyway, I'll never forget. I was like 19 years old or something. Yeah, it's crazy.
Ay, ay, ay. Well, let's hear what Katie has to say about her experience taping episode 18, The Thing in the Road.
You gotta love a good sister story. What can I say? Even though this is a very sad one, scary one. But yeah, I have sisters, so it was fun and easy for me to tap into.
If you like what you're hearing, hit us up on Apple Podcasts and not only rate the show, but write a review. It helps the show get found. And every time we do a post show, we'll share your review right here, like Chrissy is about to do now.
Oh, are you guys ready for this?
We are ready.
So ready.
Bring it.
This is from Old School Bizzo, Lost in My Imagination, 5 stars. Every story is perfectly described in a way that your imagination cannot help but take over and paint the picture in your mind. I love every second of what I hear. I'll be recommending this podcast to everyone I know. Thank you. Wow, that's so
thank
nice.
Thank you.
I hope they amazing. Every second they like.
Even when you're telling them long story about the guy shooting himself in the face.
They feel the same way about the post show.
Yeah. Please get those.
I think not.
Just before we wrap up here, what's going on in your guys' life next? What are we all going to do, actually? We're all doing this. We're going to see each other for the first time in a long time later this week.
Yeah, we're going to go to Delusion. Lauren, tell us. You know the most about Delusion. I've done it once with you guys, but we're very excited. You tell them about it.
It is so awesome. Well, this year it's in Pomona.
An old haunted house.
Yes. And they choose different locations. And usually it's in like West Adams, right?
Yeah. Different historic buildings all across LA. Sometimes it's an old hospital, a historic mansion,
a church. And basically it's a play that is acted out right in front of you. It's horror play. And then you get to be part of the play. It's very interactive and you move the play along and it has this beautiful score and just great actors. Like the first one, I had to like climb into a ditch that was like 6 feet and hop on a coffin and pull a key off of a fake skeleton.
Well, I remember that.
And then climb out and then we unlock something. It's always
crazy. You have a breakdown in the one and they had to pull you out or something? You had a little mental breakdown.
Yay, I can't wait.
It was in the basement, right?
Well, I'm super claustrophobic.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And they locked us in this dark
basement.
Basement.
Well, wasn't there a jail in it or a demon was down there? Something was down there.
Yeah.
But they used that. They used that for the review after. Remember, they capitalized on that. Because it was
How have I known this long? You've never told me this. This is like,
because it's freaking embarrassing. Now it's telling everybody that listens to our fucking show.
Well, so. What one did they go to? Oh, the blue blade one.
That
right?
was more adventure.
Yeah, it was more like a sci-fi kind. And I fucked it up. Remember, I got all the clues. I didn't keep the right stuff. And
yeah, I remember they sent me to answer. The phone was ringing. Like yeah, you yeah. go. Phone and then I realized I didn't listen to anything the person was saying. Like, what did he say? I'm like, I don't know. I wasn't listening. And then it was like all the clues we needed, and I'm terrible.
We're really great to go with, yeah, so make sure you come in our group because
well, that's why we have our own group so we can not fuck up everyone else's night.
So is there a link where we can see Lauren's breakdown, or is that something we can post at the end of the show?
Probably there's an old Yelp. I don't think it's the breakdown. I don't think was captured on video.
Thank God.
Unfortunately.
Yeah. No.
Oh,
that was terrifying.
I'm laughing now. It'll probably be me this time. So
remember, they were asking. That was the one where they asked each girl if they were on their period before they went in. Right.
God. Yeah. I was like, what the hell? Weird.
Like a girl witch or whatever came up to you, right? It was a satanic play. That is one, it, I
so
think.
Now they ask you. They ask you if you've been vaccinated, and then if you're on your period. It's like a little
yeah. yeah, that was really weird. I think I said, actually, I'm pregnant.
You might have been.
I was.
I mean, you're mostly pregnant.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
You, okay.
Not right now.
Not right now. Not right now. Not right now.
Or ever again, but.
Yeah.
but yeah, I'm pregnant a lot.
Yeah. Well, this is a weird post show.
This is a very post show. A weird post show.
Hey, we did go through a haunted maze today, though.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
the, do like, tell.
The Toluca Lake Florist or something set it up. We brought our 2-year-old.
It's just a pumpkin patch, but they had a little cool like walk through haunted maze for like kids. But it was fun. It was cool. Like, aww, they actually did a good job. I was like, this is as good as Universal Halloween Horror Nights. Oh, there was like no one here. No, we were the only ones there. It was great.
Yeah, she was into it. She was like, oh, he's a big guy. And I was like, yeah, she wasn't scared, but she was into it. So that's cool.
is that, I think we've been to that one. Is it behind the actual flower shop, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we took Scarlett there when she was little.
Classic. Yes. Next up for Scarlett, McCamey Manor.
Oh, fuck no.
Yeah. And what is the other one? Is it Blackout? The one in Vegas or something? Isn't that what it was called?
Blackout, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, heard of Blackout.
That would be really fun. Yeah, get the kids involved.
All right, everybody. Well, thanks for listening. Follow us at Bleeders Digest. That's DIE on Twitter and Instagram and bleedersdigest.com. And we need a sign off. You know how Elvira says like unpleasant dreams and is there anything? Anyone got anything?
Mahalo. Love line.
Love line.
Sorry.
No, I don't have one. But we could try and come up one for the next. This is reason to listen next week.
Right.
How about pronounce? Just don't drive in the middle of nowhere at night. That'll be a good,
it's
good
a message. Terrible catch.
I'm sorry. I don't know.
Don't drive.
We'll think of one.
But what do they say in the prayer? What's the prayer? The prayer at the end of the story again. I forget the words.
Time moves evil in this lost land. It will come for you. It is not a man. Evil in its walk, evil in its breath. Something, and no one's ever left.
Again. We'll work on this, guys.
Our next review is going to be like, whatever you do, do not listen to the post show. Just stick with the story. The end, all bad.
Yeah, they're like, there's no way these idiots are writing these stories.
Oh, good times. Well, that was fun, guys.
It was.
And it ends.